Good evening. It's 8 o'clock on a tragic, tragic day for India. 40 CRPF Jawans have been killed in the worst terror attack against security men in Kashmir ever. Reports say that an explosives-laden car driven by a terrorist rammed into a CRPF bus with at least 40 Jawans on board. The scenes of carnage show the scale of attack. The car was apparently loaded with about 350 kilograms of explosives. The terrorist driving the car, according to the police, was Aadil Ahmed, who joined the Jaish last year. The Prime Minister has condemned this despicable attack, saying the sacrifice won't go in vain. Other opposition parties, there's been condemnation across the nation. Priyanka Gandhi Vadra cancelled her Uttar Pradesh press conference, saying in a statement, "I demand the government ensure no such future attacks." What exactly happened? Just look at the images of this devastation. Vishnu has more on that. Vishnu, the worst ever attack in Jammu and Kashmir against security men on one of the most heavily guarded highways, the Srinagar-Pulwama highway. Tell us what you know at this stage.
Well, Sonia, it is an absolutely horrific attack. It's an attack against a convoy which had 78 vehicles and 2,500 personnel of the CRPF travelling from Jammu to Srinagar. The attack took place at approximately 3:37 p.m. this afternoon when a vehicle which was either stationary with explosives exploded or was in fact mobile and rammed into one of the buses. The soldiers who were on that bus have almost all been killed. Likely all of them on one particular bus have been killed. And the images which we cannot show our viewers indicate that that particular vehicle, that bus which exploded, has been all but has been completely destroyed. It's just a black, charred mess right now. We also do know that many of the soldiers are in critical condition. And at this stage, I think what we can all do is try and pray that those soldiers who are very badly injured are somehow managed to make it alive. This was about 20 kilometers outside Srinagar in Awantipora, where this blast took place. Presumably, other vehicles from the convoy would have taken the soldiers who were injured and taken them to the Army Base Hospital. This is a hospital which is actually got some of the most trained personnel anywhere to deal with shrapnel injuries, bullet wounds, and blast injuries. The golden hour is absolutely important, but I think the CRPF, which is hesitating and coming out with the numbers itself, did say something revealing about an hour back when they told journalists that the doctors will need to confirm the final toll. The point is this, Sonia. It's not just the soldiers who died in the blast at the blast site. It's now a fight for survival for many of those who may have initially survived. How many of them have perished, we don't know. But the numbers, as you mentioned, at this stage, about 40.